I'm Sheena Davis with Black Sports Online and Out of the Box with Sheena Marie. I just wanted to catch up with you just to get your spin on your involvement with the Remote Music Conference and what you hope to give attendees as far as your knowledge in the music industry.
My involvement is just wanting to give back. I've taken a community and a village to help me get to where I am in my own personal career. So anytime I can take to just dedicate my time and resources to helping, give other people opportunities and the knowledge to help them chase their dreams, I'm always available for that. On top of that, I have so much respect for Puff and Andre Harrell and the people that I looked at growing up and inspired to be like. So, anything I can do to be a part of something they're doing, I want to be a part of that automatically because I'm still a sponge. I want to learn as much as I can learn. So I'm here to give out knowledge, but I'm also going to panels and talking to people and just gaining any knowledge I can gain. I never want to stop being able to be in a position to learn. So I'm here for like a two-part situation. I'm here to give back and also learn. So,
now, how did you get involved in the music business? How did you start out?
It's like a complicated question, my father's in the Temptations, so I grew up around the music business, so that's part of it. I didn't get in the business that way, but I was kind of born into it. But on my own, one of my best friends was a producer, and him and myself started a production company in Philly, and met this kid named Sparks, who was a part of State Property, and he took me up to Rockefeller, and the rest is kind of history. I met Biggs, who was one-third Rockefeller, and he gave me an opportunity. There's so many different ways that people gave me opportunities, but one thing just always led to another, and I was hungry. I've done crazy things to get in. That's probably like an hour long conversation, but I hustled my way to where I'm at for sure.
You definitely could have benefited from something like RMC as you were kind of moving through the ranks and getting the knowledge from all of these different these brilliant minds that are in the entertainment.
Absolutely, I definitely. You had a conference where a lot of influential people are walking around. It only takes that one person to notice you, to see something. I judged a talent thing yesterday, and the kid I picked, he actually won it. So, one of the winners. Who knows what that'll lead to, but it only took for him to perform in front of me, for me to think it was good, push him through to the finals. Next, he's on the stage in front of everybody, and he won. So, little things like that, one thing leads to another, can change your life. So,
So you talked about influence on social media. In this age, I know it wasn't really around, when you were starting out. I'm not calling you old or anything like that, but it's kind of, it wasn't around, when I was younger either, so it's fairly new. Do you feel like that can hurt it as much as it can help an artist's chances as far as like the accessibility and like pretty much people's eyes always being on you and being able to go back and refer to things that you may have done when you were a little bit more immature and, not really watching the way you move?
I think that the good thing about social media is that you can get yourself out there way easier than when I was trying to get on. When I was trying to get on, it was a lot of long rides to New York and back from Philly with a 5-minute meeting or trying to figure out how I could get in front of somebody. On social media, you can get directly to a lot of influential people. So I think they're all positives. I think we're all young and immature sometimes.
Right.
So, we all do a couple of stupid things. So, you just got to know that and know that stuff on social media lives forever. And you just got to be smart about how you operate.
Okay, one last question for you. I do a lot of work in sports, and a lot of controversy is centered around Donald Trump and the national anthem and things like that, as far as them feeling like he's trying to censor people's opinions. Hip hop has always had a prominent role in politics, speaking out against injustices. What do you feel about that right now with what's going on between politics and just the culture, period?
Well, I think that I think music has always been, always will be, probably the strongest platform and voice to not only get a message across but bring people together. And I think for a while in music, I don't want to, you know, not disrespecting it, but a lot of music has been disposable. So I think right now more than ever.
That's a politically correct way to put it.
I think right now more than ever, it's important for artists to, you know, create some music that means something.
Right.
You know, a lot of the music I grew up on, listening, you know, being around my parents listening to music, you know, was a lot of Motown, a lot of Philly International music, and a lot of that stuff was definitely politically driven.
Right.
Right. And definitely a message in the music. I think that, you know, we could use getting back to that a little bit, of just being inspired by what's going on in the world to, you know, give out positive messages to help make the world a better place. But I think music is definitely a great platform to do it, because I feel like it's one of the things, you know, music and sports that bring people together from, you know, all
that. Definitely. Thank you for your time.
Absolutely. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Can you get a photo real quick? You know, yeah.